Hi everybody, this is Olivia from the Alexandrian Channel, and today we are going to doodle some branches that can be used as dividers and borders. I wanted to cover just a couple of different ways to do it, one using the Sharpie, the fine and the ultra fine, and maybe a little bit of a dry brush look and some different colors. So if you like this video, I would really appreciate it if you'd give it a thumbs up, and I'd love it if you would comment and subscribe and hit the bell notification so you'll be notified when I post new videos. Thanks. There's a lot of times that we know what something looks like until we go to draw it, and then we realize that we need to actually go look at whatever it is. Everybody knows what a tree branch looks like, but you should take another look at them if you're going to draw them, and that probably goes with anything. And when you look at them, you'll realize how rough that these really are. Okay, continuing on. And some branches are more like this, you know, kind of one line. And then you can get them to where they go way out. But then, you know, that might be more like a tree, not a border. So we'll go like that. Maybe we'll add a couple little offshoots here and there. And like right there, see how it looks kind of rough? That's fine because trees actually do look kind of rough. And about the only thing to remember is that as you go out, they get smaller. Larger here and smaller as you go out further. And then maybe like that. Okay. One more with this one. I'll make this one kind of a big one. And I'm gonna kind of mess it up a little bit on purpose. Make this a little globby there. And it's really not gonna make a big difference. Okay, add a little bit of width there. Okay, now I'm gonna make a few with the marker that's more slender. I like both of them, it just depends on what you're doing. But these, because they're fine, look scratchier. Okay, and then up here, we'll go off into two. It depends on how much room you want or need. You can make these pretty wide, or you can make it just one like long branch, like so, maybe with a couple little twiggy things coming off. But this particular item, the branch, is very, very easy to draw because they're supposed to look rough. Okay. And this really does give a good impression of a tree branch. There we go. A page of branches, dividers, or borders. I just thought I'd mention that this is the perfect time of year for this type of border. It's the branches that have no leaves, so it's great for autumn, winter, and potentially early spring. Now I want to cover kind of a dry brush look. If you have a marker that's almost dead, that's perfect. You know, if it's almost dried out, that's really, really good because it makes it look even better. You can see how it has kind of a rougher textured look. And just quickly go over it. And if you leave the top part blank, it kind of looks like this is the shadow. That's the only one I have that's about dry. But you can go in with a lighter one on top and it'll do the same thing. Look like the sun is coming down this way. And then if you wanted to, let's see if there's one that's a little darker. Now it looks like the sun's coming, more at this kind of an angle. Because we've got the three colors. Anyway, okay. And now if we put a really dark one on there, if I can find it. See, this might be it. Now again, this is if you're wanting a quick border. You can take as much time, put little knots in them and a bunch of the little bitty branches. Okay, let's make a lighter colored one. And again, you'll notice how rough I'm being. I'm not being particular at all. You can have one of these borders done in about a minute or two. I think that one looks good, just like that. But I'll add a little bit of a darker color to it. Now you can just kind of go like that if you're not, wanting to know which direction the sun is or anything like that. You just add some this darker color just here and there. Okay. See how light is that? Okay. Can you tell I'm getting into what I'm doing? I keep going. Okay. All right. Now, say if you had, I think I have the color here, like a birch tree. I will use one of these branches because they look a little, I don't know, more like what I would think a birch might look like. Just put a little bit of gray on it, and then it would look more like a birch. And if you wanted to, I don't know if this will work well. Yeah. You know how it looks like they have little kind of cross hatches here and there? You could do that if you wanted to. That would add a little bit. All right, let's see now what do we have? Kind of a goldy color. I like the brush tips on the markers. Still have a ways to go to where I'm proficient with them, but I'm learning that I do like those brush tips. They feel really smooth. Easy to work with. Okay. Looks very similar to that one. Maybe if we add a little bit of dark contrast. And when you have the little pieces of white show through, that actually looks better than covering the entire thing because it makes it have depth. It makes it look a little more painterly. If you're into that sort of thing. Oh. Now this one will be good because we're gonna see, like I told you, I was deliberately kind of messing that up. I wanted to see how we might make it look like it's not messed up. If we can do that. Okay. That already makes it look like it's not messed up. Yes, it does. Maybe make a little branch come off of that. Brush tip. Love it. Just put another line there. And then maybe make a couple more lines to make it look like you deliberately did that. There. Ta-da! Now it looks a little bit more like that is what you intended to do. I guess I'm one of these, I really don't want to redo something if I don't have to. So if I can find a way to make it look like I wanted it to, then I'd rather just leave it at that. That looks fine. I do think if you're trying to fix something like that, adding more black lines in different spots helps it because it looks like it, you did it that way deliberately. Maybe put a couple deliberate ones in there. Yeah, there you go. So that's how you fix one if you kind of goober it up. Okay, the birch one looks very birchy. Oh, and you can do the same thing with these that you did with that if you want. Like I said, if you want to take more time, you can make little marks like that, or little knots. I don't know if I'd use black, maybe a little bit. Okay, well, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you learned something and can go make some tree branch borders. If you like this video, I would appreciate it if you'd give it a thumbs up, and I'd love it if you would subscribe and hit the bell notification so you'll be notified when I post new videos. Have a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye.